よう、ヤッホー春日くん。
この野郎、もうすっかり馴染んでやがんな、蝶。
ああ、酒はやっぱボディーガードなしで飲む方がうまいよ。
なるほど、その辺はさすがにハンピン・リューマンの元総帥か。
俺の場合は生まれながらのね、そこらの人とはちょっと苦労してるとこが違う。
ギャングの跡取り息子の愚痴ね。酒の魚には良さそうだ。
人の人生をおつまみ扱い。ふん、まあ春日君も苦労人だし、いっか。
確かお前の親父さんがハンピン・リューマンの先代だったっけ。今はどうしてんだい。
引退してから何年かして死んだよ。誰かに撃たれたり刺されもせず、ベッドの上で。
そいつは良かったってことになるのかな。
ギャングのボスだった割にはね。四六時中誰かに襲われないか警戒してたけど、ま、あんまり羨ましい人生じゃないよ。俺だって別になりたくて総帥になったわけじゃない。多分真淵なんかの方が組織のボスには向いてたろうね。
真淵、ラオマか。あれ、そういやお前、あいつのことどうした。オウミと手組んでたとこぶっ倒して、それっきり見てねえけど。
ハンピン・リューマンが裏切り者にするお仕置きといえば、まんじゅうの具にしちゃうんだよ。
は？おい、じゃあ真淵もか。嘘だろ。
どうかね、俺がそんなことする人間に見える。
いや、全然そうは見えねえよ。真淵はお前の仲間だったんだろ。たとえ裏切り者でもお前は仲間をまんじゅうにするような人間じゃねえはずだ。
ありがとう、そんな風に俺を見てくれてたわけか。確かに真淵をまんじゅうにはしてないけど、俺はあいつに拷問を受けた身ではある。
つまりどういうことだ。真淵を殺したのか。
優しいね、春日君は。真淵のこと心配してあげてんだ。
俺には別に殺されてめでたいと思う人間なんていねえよ。
でも真淵には野々宮ってソープの店長を殺されたでしょ。
なあ、だから理想としちゃ真淵を半殺しにして、その後殺に突き出してやりたかった。
ところが半殺しにしたとこへ近江の幹部たちが来た。それで真淵のことは忘れちゃってた。
お前本当に真淵を殺したのか。
結論から言うとだね、実は殺してない。
そうか。なんかそんな気はしてた。
なんで。
なんつうかお前はさ、変なこだわりみてえなのあんま感じねえんだ。組織がこうでなきゃいけねえってよりは、部下の手前ボスらしくしてただけっつうか。
結構失礼なこと言ってるよ春日君。
でも実際真淵のことは殺さなかったんだろ。お前は多分閉じ込めたり拷問とかもしてない。
ふん、狭い土地で生きてきた仲間同士だからね、その命取るほどのことなんてまずないんだよ。とはいえ今ハンピン・リューマンは孫妃の預かりじゃん。彼女は真淵から見たらけじめをつけなきゃならない立場だ。コミジュルは真淵の陰謀で家を焼かれているし、それを閉めるとなったらもう殺すしかないよね。
かもな。
だからその前に真淵には俺が行って偉人町を出て行かせたんだ。
町を追放するだけで済ませてやったってことか。
真淵についていった手下たちも何人かいたけど、偉人町に戻る気があるやつは許してあげた。つまり一旦リセット、全部チャーラー。孫妃もそれで了解してくれてる。
寛大なこって。悪名高い偉人さんが丸くなったもんだな。
マブチはハンピン・リューマンの稼ぎ頭で功労者だったしさ。まあ組織に内緒の仕事で溜め込んでもいたけど。
お前そういうの知ってたのに見て見ぬふりしてたわけか。
親父の代からいた古参の幹部たちは怒ってたよ。マブチは組織の掟をないがしろにしているってね。でも偉人町は日本でも屈指のグレーゾーンだよ。なら少しくらいのズルは多めに見なきゃ。
なるほど言えてるな。
じゃどこかで元気してるであろうマブチに乾杯と行こうか。
別にあんなやつどうだっていいけど。まあいいさ、寛大な元総帥に免じて付き合うよ。
そう来なくちゃね。誰が来るかと思ってたら春日君か。忙しいんじゃないの？飲んでる場合だっけ？
余計なお世話だぜ長。いつ飲もうが俺の勝手だろ。だいたいこの店は俺が先に常連だったんだ。
あれそういう風に来る？それ言ったら偉人町じゃ春日君の方がずっと新参じゃん。
確かに
先輩風っていうのはどこで吹かせても恥ずかしいもんだね。
分かったよ、そっちの勝ちだ。
ふん、じゃあまあとにかく座りないよ。
しかしなんだな、こうして飲んでるとお前が組織のボスだったとは見えねえよな。
そりゃそうだよ、一皮むけば誰だって同じ。裸になっちゃえばそいつが権力者かどうか金持ちか貧乏かも分かりゃしないでしょ。
確かに人間は見た目じゃないよな、肝心なのは中身だ。
そういうこと。なんだ話が早いね春日君。
当然のことを言ったまでよ。
つまり人の上に立つ人間を誰にするかってのはその中身を見て決めるべきなわけ。なのにボスの息子だから組織を継がせなきゃとか、まあ合理的な考え方とは言えないよね。
人間生まれる場所は選べねえさ。けどどうしても嫌だっつって断る道はなかったのか。だいたい組織のボスなんて誰にでもできるもんじゃねえんだ。周りがお前をボスの器じゃないと見りゃ他の誰かが組織を継いだろうぜ。
器かどうかは知らないけど、俺は昔いい子でさ、勉強もスポーツもやればすぐにできたわけ。ついでに言うと喧嘩も負けた記憶ないし、悪知恵もそこらの悪よりずっと回ってたね。
なんだよ、めちゃくちゃ才能があったんじゃねえか。
ないのはやる気だけだったよ。何してもそつなくできる器用貧乏の差がってわけ。
嫌味な野郎だね。
親父から代替わりするまでは中華街の方にも強敵がいて張り合いもあったんだけどさ、ところがそこのラウカーロンってボスが消えて結局偉人さんの三すくみだけが残った。
中華街の組織っていうとジャカか。噂に聞いたことはあるぜ、ヤバい連中だったって。
日本からとっくに撤退してったよ。残党だってほとんど残ってない。
そのジャカがいなくなった頃にお前はハンピン・リューマンの総帥になったと。
そうだね、だいたい10年前かな。正直言って面倒なだけだったよ。例の荻窪の偽札のこともその時に知らされた。他に偉人町の三すくみや霊戦が実は筋書きのある出来レースだったってこともね。
なああれか。
その事情を知ってたのはリューマンの中じゃ親父とその同世代の古参幹部だっけ。下の若いのは偉人町を全部手にしたいって言うけど、俺はそれを押さえつける側だよ。 そうなると総帥は弱腰だって言われるわけ。面白い仕事じゃないでしょ、そう思わない？
だいぶ素の顔が見えてきたじゃねえか、蝶。思ったより酒が入ってたみてえだな。
もう組織を背負っているわけじゃないんだから、好きなだけ酔わせてもらう。悪いかよ。
そんなことは言ってねえ。楽しい酒だって言ってんだよ。
楽しい酒か。まあ確かに少し手札を見せすぎたかね。前だったらボディーガードが止めてくれてたんだけど。
おっと、どうやら水を刺しちまったか。
春日君は野暮なことも全部口に出しちゃうからな。俺は少し酔いを覚ましてくるよ。
そうかい、気が向いたらまた飲んでやってもいいぜ。
いいね、その言葉そっくり返すよ。
ああ楽しみにしとく。
よう春日君、先に一杯やらせてもらってるよ。
そうかい、ご機嫌で何よりだ、蝶。なら俺も少しやってくかな。一緒にいいか。
望むところだよ。ちょうど一人で飲むのに飽きてたとこ。
ここんとこハンピンリューマンの連中はどうしてんだ。誰もおめんとこに出入りしてねえのか。
そんなことないけど、まあマブチについてた連中はさすがに遠慮してこないね。
そりゃそうだろうな、裏切ってクーデターに加勢してた奴らってことだろう。連中が総帥よりマブチについた理由ってのはお前も気になるんじゃねえの。
別に。けどマブチは部下にしてみれば分かりやすいリーダーであったろうとは思うよ。
分かりやすいって何が。
マブチの欲しがってるもの、金と力を満たしてくれる部下をマブチは必ず評価する。掟を守らないとか暴力が過ぎるとか、そんなのお構いなしにどんどんやれるやつをね。
喧嘩の腕と度胸さえあれやバカでも上に引き上げられるってか。
たとえ他の仲間を蹴落としたりしてもだよ、マブチにさえ忠誠を誓っていれば。
むちゃくちゃだな。けどいつだったかマブチはああ見えてインテリだって聞いたぜ。
ああ、あいつは何カ国語も喋れたし、数字に強くて暴力にもためらいがない。裏社会で言うと逸材だよね。もし登場会にいたら当然春日君より出世してたでしょ。
歴史にたらればはねえんだ。俺は無所の中で生きるのが運命だったんだよ。
そうだね、すまなかった。今のは俺の失言だったよ春日君。
そんなつもりで言ったんじゃねえって。謝る必要なんかねえさ。
そっか、まあとにかく俺が言いたかったのは、若き日のマブチには才能があったってことでね。俺も総帥になった時そこを見込んで、マブチには右腕になってくれって言ったし。
は？なんだよそれ。じゃあお前があいつに力をつけさせちまった張本人か。
ああ、なるほど。確かにそうなるね。
のんきに笑ってんじゃないよ。
でもあの頃のマブチはそれくらい魅力的な人間だったんだよ。今みたいに裏でうじうじやるような感じじゃなかったんだ。俺もあいつに惹かれてて。
どんなところに。
若い頃のマブチにはこう、なんていうかさ、向上心みたいなのがすごくあったんだよ。のし上がってやるっていう気持ちが溢れてて、それを叶えるだけの才能もあって、俺にはないものをあいつは持ってた。だから惹かれたのかもしれないね。そう、ちょうど春日君みたいな感じかな。よくよく考えたら結構似てるかも。
おいおい、やめてくれよ。で、そんな魅力的なマブチが変わっちまったのは何でなんだ
今思えばあいつが幹部になったのがきっかけかもしれない。幹部になってからあいつは同年代で格上の俺に露骨に立てつくようになっていった。生まれだけで総帥を継いで弱腰の協調路線を続ける俺が気に食わなかったんだろうね。マブチはイケイケタイプだし、どう考えても俺って存在は邪魔だしうざいよね。
ならいつかマブチは裏切るかもしれねえって超も思ってたんじゃねえのか。
いや俺はそんなに、なんだかんだあいつのことを信じてたのかもしれない。でも親父や子さんの幹部たちはマブチをよく思ってなかった。あいつはきっといつか裏切るから早めに消した方がいい、そう言ってマブチを消そうと動いたんだ。
それでどうなったんだ。
俺が必死に止めたよ。前にも言ったと思うけど、俺は内輪で殺し合うなんてバカバカしいと思ってる。しかも組織はこの先老人たちじゃなくて俺とマブチで背負ってこうって時期じゃん。マブチみたいな人間を潰すってことは未来を潰すってことにもつながる。だから反対した。なかなか老人たちも納得してくれなくてね。土下座したのは人生であれが最初で最後さ。
マブチのためにそこまで。自分を嫌ってる人間のためにどうして。
マブチは確かに癖もあるし悪いところも山ほどある。嫌なやつだしね。だけど俺にはない熱もあるし才能もある。それに何より俺はあいつを仲間だと思ってた。仲間を殺したくない、守りたいって思うのは当然でしょ。
そうだな。すまない、野暮なこと聞いたぜ。
春日君が野暮なこと聞くのはいつものことさ。気にすることないよ。
だけどよ、なんか俺嬉しいぜ。
何が。
蝶が意外と熱い人間だってことを知れてさ。
俺が熱い。
ああ、正直いつものらりくらりかわされるから本当の蝶ってどんなやつかつかみきれてない気がしてた。でもこうやって酒を飲みながら向き合って蝶がどんなやつなのか改めて分かった気がするぜ。なんだかんだで仲間思いの熱いやつ、俺が好きなタイプの人間さ。
面と向かってそれ言われると恥ずかしいね。
顔が赤いぜ。照れてんのか。
酔ってるんだよ。もう一杯飲もうか。
ああ、仲間思いの超先輩に乾杯。
乾杯。春日君、ちょうどいいや、待ってたんだよ。
ん？なんだよ、何かあったのか。
というわけで結論から言うとさ、偉人町にマブチが舞い戻ってきたってこと。
は？マジか。だってあいつ偉人町追放されたはずだろ。
ね、困っちゃうよね。マブチのやつせっかく見逃してあげたのにさ。
わざわざ偉人町に戻ってきたってことは、あいつハンピン・リューマンに返り咲く気か。
どうかな。もうそんな力は残ってないはずだけど、手下はほとんどあいつの元から逃げてったし。
じゃあまた近江連合を後ろ盾にしてるとか。
今の真淵に近江がそこまでする利用価値はないかな。
ん？じゃあよ、マブチが戻ってきたとこで別に大した脅威じゃねえのか。
多分そういう状況だと思う。マブチはもうすっかり落ち目だよ。嬉しい？
おごれるもの久しからずか。一時期は偉人帳を陰で操るくらいだったのにな。
ただ前にも言ったかもしれないけど、問題は損費さ。
なあ、コミジュルを燃やした張本人のマブチが戻ってきて、何もしなかったら示しがつかねえもんな。
そう、今は彼女がハンピン・リューマンのトップ。 真淵が戻ってきたのを知ったら間違いなく彼女は真淵を殺す。
だろうな。で、お前はこの状況をどうしたいんだ。
コミジルが動く前にもう一度真淵を偉人町から追い出したい。
見殺しにはしたくねえってことか。あんたを裏切ったやつなのに。
ね、つくづく自分は甘い男だと思うよ。なんだかんだあいつのこと仲間だと思っちゃってる。もう仲間でも何でもない。自分を殺そうとさえ思っている天敵なのにね。
甘い男でいいじゃねえか。俺はそういう男の方が好きだぜ。なんだよ、ちょっとやっぱり人間くせんだな。ちゃんと人間なんだなお前。
春日君、僕を何だと思ってたんだい。失礼な人だね。
だがコミジュルより先に動くとしたら、そうのんびりもしてられねえな。もし真淵の居場所が分かったらすぐに動かねえと。俺でよかったら手貸すから行ってくれよな。
春日君、ありがとう。お人よしだね君は。
お人よしは嫌いか。
いや嫌いじゃない、むしろ好きだね。
ならよかった。
ここに来てるってことは、春日君今は時間があるってことだよね。
だったらなんだよ。
酒入れる前にちょっと付き合ってくんない。真淵に会いに行くから。
ってことは奴のアジトが分かったのか。
そう、実はあいつの方から使いの人間が来てね。
使いの人間？いや、お前、定価？真淵からの使いって、なんでお前が真淵とつるんでんだ？あいつはお前なんか全然相手にしてなかったろ。
うるせえ！今のラオマンは、この俺を頼りにしてくれてんだよ。
こりゃ、相当真淵は手下に逃げられたんだろうな。残ってる人材が貧弱すぎるぜ。
んだと？
まあまあ聞き流してやってよ。てで、どこに行けば真淵に会えるのかな。
ええ、それならご案内します。この俺の後についてきていただければ。
ちょっと待てよ、そもそも真淵は俺らに何の用なんだ。
偉人町に復帰のお許しを願いたいと。言っとくがお前にじゃねえぞ春日、総帥にだ。
今のリューマンは俺じゃなくて孫妃の仕切りなんだけど、それは承知してる？
はい、まずはとにかく総帥に詫びを入れたいとラオマーはそう言っています。
コミジルは家を燃やされてる。真淵が許される見込みはまずないと思うけど。
それも承知の上です。
なのに謝りたいって。真淵はそんな玉じゃねえだろ。罠か。
多分ね。でもいずれにしても真淵に会うにはこの話に乗るしかない。
そうだな、よし行こう。おい、ここって見覚えあるぜ。俺らが真淵に監禁された地下道だ。
コミジルの目を避けられる場所は少ねえからな。
ビビって抜かよかすが。
口に気ぃつけねえとまた痛い目見んぞ。
チ
ッ、春日君ストップ。
ん？
注意して、後ろを塞がれたよ。
何？話が違うんじゃねえか長。真淵にはもうほとんど手下がいねえはずだって。
思ってたよりは残ってたね。やっぱりそこそこ人望はあるらしい。
言われた通りにやりましたよラーマン。
久しぶりだな、チョウ。
また会えるとは思ってなかったよ、マブシ。
許しをくれってことで呼び出されたはずだがな、実はそうじゃなかったってことか。
ああ、お前らの首を差し出せば俺は今度こそ近江連合の席に加われる。
あ、まだそんなこと言ってんのか。
金と力を手に入れるためには手段は選ばねえ。満たされねえ野心だけが俺の生きる糧よ。
近江のそんな話に踊らされやがって、ずいぶん落ちこぼれたな、マブッチ。
いつまでそのにやけ面でいられる。景品飯店の拷問を思い出せ。またあの続きをやるぞ。
くだらない。もうやめよう、マブチ。俺はこれ以上哀れなお前の姿を見たくない。
へっ、減らず口よ。
マブチよ、チョウはお前のこと心配してんだぞ。チョウはお前に死んでほしくねえんだよ。心のどっかで今もお前を仲間だって思ってんだよ。目覚ませよ、バカ。
黙れ、カスガ、この野郎。忘れてねえぞ、てめえのせいで俺らは。
おい、人の話を聞けって。
いいよ、カスガ君。いい加減ムカついてきた。このバカにはもう拳で分からせるしかない。ここから先はキャラ変わっちゃうかもしれないけど、みんなにはオフレコにしておいてね。
で、
おい、まぶしい。
そんなに俺が憎いんなら世間工作なんかしねえで正面からぶつかってこいや。俺の首取れるもんなら取ってみやがれ。
絶対許さねえ。ぶっ殺してやる。
ほら、上がってこいよ。俺の番だな。取っておきだ。
やんないね。
来てみろ。
やってやるよ。
さて。覚悟しねえよ。
よいしょ。
それ。黙れ。ダ
ン。
いいね。まった本気でやって。
ぞ。
強くなった気がするぜ。
くせえ。ラオマ、仲間は全滅です。もうこれ以上は。
これが最後の警告だ。 今すぐ偉人町を出て行け。その日ももうお前がいることには気づいてる。このまま居残ってたら命はねえんだぞ。
コミジョルのメラだ。どうにでもかいくぐってみせる。
お前、いい加減にしろよ。今までお前が見逃されてたのは、ソンヒが俺の気持ちを汲んでくれていたからだ。俺がお前を殺したくねえっていう気持ちをな。
蝶、
マブシ、お前は俺を嫌いだろ。俺もお前だけ大嫌いだ。だけどよ、どんだけ嫌いでも、どんだけ腐っても、やっぱりお前は俺の仲間なんだよ。俺はよ、仲間を殺したくねえんだよ。お前に死んでほしくねえんだよ。伝えたいことは伝えて、あとはお前次第だ。死ぬか、ここを去るか、好きにするといい。どちらにしても一生のお別れだ。じゃあな、ラオマ。
いくせ。
帰ろう、春日君。久々にでかい声を出して喉が渇いたからか、いつもより酒がうまいね。
なら、これからもさっきみたいにでけえ声出せばいいじゃねえか。
いやだよ、疲れるし、俺のキャラじゃな。はあ、格好悪いとこ見せちゃったな。
そうか、俺はさっきの蝶好きだけどな。本当のおめえが見れた気がして嬉しかったぜ。やっぱりひょうひょうとしてるようで、実は熱い男なんだな、蝶は。
やめてくれよ、今の俺が本当の俺さ。さっきのことはみんなにはオフレコで頼むよ。
どうしよっかな。
ふん、そんなこと言って絶対言わないでしょ。春日君は約束破らないもんね。
わからないぜ。
わかるよ、大事な仲間のことくらいわかるさ。
そうかい。なら今俺が思ってることわかるか。
ああ、もう一杯飲みたいんだろ。
正解だ、飲もうぜ、ちょ。
ああ、
Yo, how goes it, Kasuga-kun?
Look at you. You're blending in already, Zhao.
You know it. Turns out drinks taste a lot better without bodyguards watching your every move.
Yeah? So that was the life of the former leader of the Yokohama Liumong.
That shit was dumped on me from the day I was born. Kind of a drag. Growing up knowing you had a fucking script.
Well, the nice thing about alcohol is it tastes better if you complain while you're drinking it.
Oh, sure. Enjoy my childhood trauma. But I guess after all the shit you've been through, you've earned it.
Your dad led the Yokohama Liumong before you, right? What's he doing now?
He died a few years after retiring. Right in his bed. He's lucky he never got shot or stabbed.
Hey, yeah. That's a real achievement for a gang boss.
Yeah, I guess so. He only managed it by sleeping with one eye open his whole life. No matter how you slice it, it's not a great way to live. I sure as hell didn't want to lead the Liu Meng. But Mabuchi, this shit was always up his alley.
You mean Lao Ma? What even happened to that guy? I haven't even seen him since we kicked his ass during the whole Omi Alliance thing.
Don't you know what the Yokohama Liu Meng does to traitors? They use him as filling that goes inside meat buns.
What? You serious? Right now, Lao Ma is... Bao Ma?
You're fucking hilarious. But I was kidding. You think I'm the kind of guy who'd do that?
Yeah, I thought it was a joke. Him being your right-hand man and everything. And you're not the kind of guy to turn a brother into a meat bun, no matter what he did.
Appreciate that. I like to think I don't give off that vibe. I did stop short of giving Mabuchi what he deserved, after all the shit he put me through.
What does that mean? Did you kill Mabuchi?
Oh, you're softer than any bun out there. Look at you all worried.
I just don't like the thought of that happening to people.
Even creeps like Mabuchi, who murdered your boss without a second thought.
Even creeps like him. All I wanted was to knock that guy's lights out and hand him to the cops.
But by the time his lights were nice and knocked out, the army showed up, and you never saw him again, did you?
You really did kill him, didn't you?
All right, I'm bored of messing with you. I didn't kill him.
Oh, had a feeling you didn't.
Why is that?
Hard to explain, but I don't get that vibe from you. Not one bit. In fact, it always kind of felt to me like your hard-ass act was just a show for your boys. A front you put on.
Ah, that's a little harsh there, eh, Kasuga-kun?
You don't strike me as the type to lock guys up or torture them, either. Especially one of your own, like Mabuchi.
He and I call the same place home. Nothing could make me take his life. But now, Songhui's in charge of the Yokohama Liu Meng. It's up to her to settle things if Mabuchi shows his face again. He's the reason Komijul's a pile of ashes, so... I don't think she'll be treating him as nice as I would.
Probably not.
Which is why I gave Mabuchi the heads up and told him to leave Ijincho.
Really? Well, that's taking things into your own hands.
A few of his boys went with him, and I forgave the ones that wanted to stick around. It's a hard reset. Clean slate for everyone. Songhui was good with that.
You two are more generous than I thought.
Mabuchi brought in a lot of cash for us, and he was damn consistent about it. The fact that he kept a bunch of shit hidden from us was an issue, but I could deal.
So you knew about it and you just let it slide?
The guys from my dad's generation were pissed, for sure. Kept saying Mabuchi was breaking sacred laws of the gang. But what did they expect from a sadist in Japan's most famous gray zone? That he'd have a moral compass or some shit?
Seriously?
How about we toast to Mabuchi, wherever he might be?
Well, he's no friend of mine, but what the hell. If you can cheer to him, I can too.
Now we're talking. I was wondering if anyone would show up. I didn't expect it to be you. Aren't you busy? Should you really be drinking right now?
I'll drink whenever the hell I want to drink, Zhao. And don't forget, I was a regular at this place before you were.
Oh, is that how you want to play it? Okay, well, if we're doing that, then who's the newcomer in Ijincho, Kasuga? You or me?
Fair point.
Man, this whole schooling you as your senpai thing sure is embarrassing.
Yeah, you win.
Anyway, sit down, yeah?
You know, when we're out drinking like this, It's hard to imagine you ever being the leader of a gang.
Everyone's the same once you strip off the mask they put on for work. Rich, poor, leader, follower, whatever. You never know what people are really like.
Right. You can't judge someone just by looks alone. The important part is what's on the inside.
You catch on fast, Kasuga-kun.
Nah, I'm just stating the obvious, man.
Gotta look at someone's character to see whether they'd be a good leader or not. All jokes aside, there's this whole idea of being next in line just because you're the boss's son. No logic in it, but it's always there.
Yeah, can't choose who your parents are. Still, wasn't there some way you could have given up the throne? Not everybody's cut out to run a gang. Nothing wrong with that. And I'm sure somebody else would have stepped up if you had stepped down. Most important thing in any group is the leader being a good fit.
I don't know if I was a good fit or not, but I was a pretty sharp kid back then. If I put my mind to it, I could excel at pretty much anything. Sports, school, all that shit. And I don't remember losing any fights either. I was a lot craftier than the other kids.
Sounds like you were pretty talented.
I just didn't give a flying fuck, that's all. Guess that's what happens when you're good at everything.
Real modest, aren't you?
Up until I swapped places with my old man, we were always fighting with our rivals in Chinatown. But after their boss, Lao Ka Long, bit the big one, the Yijin Three got their stalemate going.
Your rivals from Chinatown? Are you talking about the Snake Flower Triad? They were pretty crazy.
They pulled out of Japan a long time ago. There's not many of them left.
Oh, so you became the leader of the Yokohama Lumong after the Snake Flower Triad was out of the picture.
Just about. Had to have been almost 10 years ago. Honestly, the whole thing was a pain in the ass. Ogi Kubo let me in on the whole counterfeit bills thing right away. Also told me about how the stalemate in Ijincho was rigged from the start.
Man, still can't hardly believe that.
The only people in the Lumong that knew about that were my dad and the old guard. The new boys kept saying they wanted to move in and take over, but it was always up to me to keep them on their leashes. Then it was no ambition this, and a weak-ass bitch that. Sounds like a fun job, eh?
Haven't seen this side of you before, Zhao. You're really starting to open up and let loose. How many have you had?
It's not like I gotta worry about the gang anymore. So I'll get as drunk as I damn well please. Is that a problem?
Hell no, it's not. I was just saying, it's been fun.
Fun, huh? Well, maybe I have shown too much of my hand. If I was still the boss, my bodyguards would have stopped me by now.
Oh, really? I hope I didn't kill your buzz.
Nah. I know you're the kind of guy that just says whatever pops into his head. I'm gonna go sober up.
Yeah, sure. Let's get another drink when you're up for it.
Sounds good. Same goes for you, all right?
Yeah, looking forward to it.
Kasuga-kun, I've already got a good buzz going.
Oh yeah? Nice. Could use one of those myself. Mind if I join you?
Sure. I was getting kind of bored drinking by myself.
So, what are the Yokohama Lumong guys up to now? Any of them ever swing by your place?
Nah, I don't see them too much. And the ones who sided with Mabuchi seem pretty hesitant to get anywhere near me.
Sounds about right. I mean, they did stage a full-on mutiny and shit. Do you ever wonder why they sided with Mabuchi instead of you?
Not really. But if I know those guys as well as I think, I'd say it was because Mabuchi was easy to understand.
Easy to understand? How you figure?
His goals were crystal clear. Everything from money and power. If rules had to be broken or blood had to be spilled, so be it.
So, in Mabuchi's world, as long as you had balls and muscle, you could work your way to the top.
Even if you stepped on your boys to get there. Long as you swore loyalty to Mabuchi.
Damn, that could get messed up fast. And I thought I heard somewhere that Mabuchi was actually pretty smart. That true?
Oh yeah. He spoke multiple languages, ran numbers better than a calculator, and most important of all, he was just fine with breaking kneecaps. He was born for the underworld. If he'd been Tojo, I bet he would have gone even farther than you.
But I guess it was fate, me getting locked up like that.
Right, sorry. I shouldn't be dredging shit like that up anyway, Kasuga-kun.
I ain't trying to make you feel guilty. No need to apologize.
Gotcha. Anyway, what I wanted to say was that the younger Mabuchi had some talent. Yeah, I even went as far as asking Mabuchi to be my right-hand man because of it.
Huh? You mean you're the guy that gave him all that power?
Oh yeah, I guess I am.
Come on, man, that's not something to laugh about.
Nah, you see, Mabuchi was just that special of a guy back then. He wasn't the type to just chill on the sidelines. Guy won me over, too.
How exactly?
When Mabuchi was younger, he just had this, I don't know, I guess you'd call it aspiration. He was going straight to the top, and he had the talent to get there, too. He had something I didn't. It's probably why I was so drawn to him. Just like you, Kasuga-kun. Now that I think about it, you two were pretty alike.
Come on, don't say that. Not when Mabuchi became such a scumbag. How'd that happen anyway?
Thinking about it now, I imagine it had something to do with him being promoted to officer. From that moment on, he would challenge me right out in the open. Didn't matter that we were roughly the same age and I outranked him. He probably didn't like that I was born into the top spots, nor that I kept up the weak cooperation policy. Mabuchi was pretty goddamn assertive. As far as I know, I was nothing but a thorn in his side.
Well, then, sounds like you should have known he'd betray you eventually.
Nah, I probably would have trusted him no matter what he said. But I know my old man and his boys didn't think too highly of him. They said he'd betray us for sure, so it would be better to get rid of him sooner rather than later. They were pretty quick to try and make him disappear.
So what'd you do?
I fought back. I probably mentioned this earlier, but I think it's really dumb when people kill the guys in their own inner circles. And this was during a time when responsibility was starting to fall to me and Mabuchi instead of the old boys. Stomping out Mabuchi was like stomping out our future. So I stood up to them. The elders were pretty tough to persuade. That's the first and only time in my life I'd grovel like that.
You did all that for Mabuchi? Why go through that for a guy who hates you?
True, Mabuchi was a fucking weirdo, and at times an evil son of a bitch. He wasn't likable either. But he had a passion I didn't have. He had talents, and above everything else, I thought of him as my brother. You can see why I don't want him dead.
You're right. Sorry, I was out of line.
I'm getting used to you doing that. Don't worry about it.
Good thing you get me.
Why is that?
Just talking like this is great. I see now you're a pretty passionate guy, Zhao.
Oh, me?
Yeah, stop fronting so much already. You're always pulling that shit. That's why I could never figure you the hell out. Now that we're a couple drinks in, I feel like I'm finally getting to know the real Zhao. You got a lot of heart, and you care about your family. That goes a long way in my book.
It's kind of embarrassing when you say it out loud like that.
Look at you, your face is all red. What's up with that?
I'm just drunk. Let's keep knocking them back, yeah?
Sure. To Zhao Senpai, for keeping it real. Cheers!
Cheers!
Ah, Kasuga-kun. Just in time. I was waiting for you.
Huh? What's up? Did something happen?
I'll get right to the point. Mabuchi's come back to Ijincho.
Wait, really? I thought you gave him and his boys the boot.
Right? Ain't that some shit? After we let him go and everything.
Yeah. Do you think he wants back in the Yokohama Lyumon?
Who knows? I don't think he has that kind of power anymore. Most of his lackeys bailed on him.
What about the Omi? Is it possible they're still backing him?
The Omi Alliance wouldn't have any use for him at this point.
Well, if that's true, wouldn't it mean his return isn't much of a threat?
That's what I'm thinking. Mabuchi's out with the trash now. Bet you're happy about that.
Maybe. But remember, he was in control of Ijincho not that long ago.
I'm sure I've said it before, but the real issue is with Songhui.
Yeah. She'd be setting a bad example if she didn't bring the hammer down on the guy who torched their home.
Yep. She's running the show now. Songhui finds out Mabuchi's back, he's as good as dead.
True. So, what do you want to do about all this?
I want to chase him off before the Komiju will make their move.
So you still won't turn your back on him? Even after all he's done?
Right. Think I'm just too soft. But when it comes down to it, he's still my brother. Even though he acts nothing like it. Guy tried to kill me for shit's sake.
Ain't nothing wrong with being soft. You're better off that way, if you ask me. I like knowing there's actually a beating heart somewhere in that chest of yours.
Don't tell me you're surprised, Kasuga-kun. Bastard.
Anyway, if we're gonna get to him before the Komi-jewel, we can't be sitting on our asses. Once we find out where he is, we're gonna have to move quick. If you need a hand, just let me know.
Kasuga-kun, thanks. You know, if anyone's a softie here, I'd say it's you.
Does that make you think any less of me?
Nah, quite the opposite. I think it's actually pretty cool.
Good shit.
Well, seeing as you're here, I imagine you got some free time right now.
What if I do?
Want to tag along with me as backup? A meeting with Mabuchi.
You found out where he's hiding?
Oh, yeah. He sent over one of his guys.
Really? Who?
Yo.
Wait, you're Zhang, right? Mabuchi sent you? Why are you on his side? Last I checked, he didn't give you the time of day.
Shut it! Lauma needs me now more than ever.
Guess he really did lose a lot of boys. The only ones left are weaklings who got nowhere else to go.
What the fuck do you say?
Easy, Zhang. Just let it go. So, are we going to Mabuchi's super secret hideout or not?
I'll take you there. Just follow me.
Hang on a sec. Just what does Mabuchi want with us?
He wants permission to return to Ijincho. And he's not asking you, Kasuga. He's asking the boss.
The Liumong's under Songhui now. You know that, right?
Yeah, but Lauma said he wants to make things right with you first.
The Komiju lost their home because of him. I don't think he has much chance of being forgiven, you know?
He knows that.
And he still wants to apologize to Zhao? That doesn't sound like Mabuchi to me. Don't you figure it's a trap?
What do you think? But if we want to see Mabuchi, we'll have to go along with it.
Yeah, you're right. Let's go. Hey, I know this place. This is the tunnel where Mabuchi locked us up.
There's very few places the Komijo's eyes don't see. You scared, Kasuga?
Watch your mouth before I put my foot in it.
Kasuga-kun, stop!
Huh?
We're blocked in.
What? Xiao, what the hell? You said he hardly had any guys left.
I guess I underestimated the number a bit. He's still got some fans.
I did just as you asked, Laoma.
Long time no see, Xiao.
Yeah. Didn't think I'd see you again, Mabuchi.
So I'm thinking Xiao ain't getting any apology from you after all. We're just here to be slaughtered.
That's right. If I offer up your heads, I'll have a seat at the Omi Alliance table for sure.
Seriously? You still hoping to move up in the world even after you've been laid so low? How's that gonna happen, man?
Money and power. Whatever it takes. This endless ambition of mine is what I live for.
Still getting played by the Omi. You're smart, but you never learn, Mabuchi.
Think you can keep up that smirk? Remember how much fun we had at Qing Jin? I say we pick up where we left off.
For fuck's sake, give it up. This is getting more pathetic by the minute.
Shut up.
Come on, Mabuchi. Can't you see? Xiao came here because he cares about you. He still sees you as his brother, even now. Wake the hell up, before you do something you can't take back.
Shut up, Kasuga, you bastard! It's your fault I'm in this mess!
No, you listen to me, damn it!
It's fine, Kasuga-kun. I'm starting to get real pissed off at our friend here. I think the only way I can get through to him is by slugging him one. You're about to see a real different side of me. So keep this shit on the down low, alright?
Huh?
Hey, Mabuchi! Why don't you cut out the sneaky shit and face me man to man? You want my head? Well, come and get it! I'm right here!
You asked for it. I'll kill you!
Play!
Let's get nutty!
Hey!
going up.
Strong.
Shit.
Lama, everyone's wiped out. We're finished.
This is the last time I'll say it. Get your ass out of Ijincho right the fuck now. Songhui already knows you're here. If you stick around, she'll kill you.
As if I'd ever let the Komijul catch me.
Damn it, Mabuchi. It's time to stop! Do you really think you can keep this up? Her guys only left you alone until now because she was doing me a favor! That's what your life hangs on, man. Just one little favor!
Xiao.
Look, I know you hate my guts. Well, guess what? I hate yours too! But no matter how much I hate you, no matter how far you fall, you're still my brother. I don't want to see you die. You hear me? I don't want you going out like that! I've said all I needed to. It's in your hands now. So you can either die or get lost. Your choice. Whenever you choose, this is goodbye. Take care, Lama.
Damn you.
Let's go, Kasuga-kun.
Sure.
I haven't had to yell like that in a while, and now I'm thirsty. Drinking really is man's only salvation.
Sounds like you're not used to yelling your real feelings like you did. Maybe you should do it more often.
No way. Wears me out. And I'll be real with you, it just ain't me. Feels lame.
You think? I kinda like that side of Zhao. It was nice feeling like I could see past those shades of yours. You act all detached from everyone, but deep down, you got a big old squirming mess of feelings, don't you?
Guess these shades don't hide shit. You'll keep this off the record, won't you?
I don't know if I should.
Well, don't fuck with me about this. Promise you won't say anything.
You never know.
But I know. You're too good a friend to pull that.
You're right about that. And you know what good friends do?
Yeah, they get too drunk to talk about that kind of shit.
Damn straight. You want to do another round?
Hell yeah.